maybe it's just me, but the term vapor pressure deficit, or VPD, immediately sounds like something bad. You know, bigly bad. You're not gonna love it. Like a $347 billion trade deficit or something you need to treat with a special ointment. Ew. Either way, you're gonna live and learn, amigos. Seriously, vapor pressure deficit, or VPD, is neither intrinsically good or bad, or infectious for that matter, thank God. It's just an advanced grow room and greenhouse metric that combines air temperature, leaf temperature, and relative humidity into a single handy unit of pressure. I'll get into the pressure part in just a moment, but for now, just note that VPD expresses how temperature and relative humidity actually affect your plants. Trust me, when you understand VPD, you are fast on your way to becoming a more intuitive and ultimately successful grower. Before you know it, you'll be writing Master Grower on your resume. Good for you, buddy. You're going to need a min-max thermometer and hygrometer to measure your grow room's temperature and relative humidity, and ideally an infrared thermometer so that you can measure the temperature of your leaves. Not all VPD calculators take this into account, but I think it's a good idea. If you don't have an infrared thermometer, position your thermometer's remote probe at canopy level and take the reading after a few minutes. Good to go. Let's do this. So, VPD is all about your plants and how they feel in your grow room. Aw, scientifically minded growers favor VPD as it provides some handy absolutes in the constant shifting world of the air's moisture holding capacity at any given temperature. You already know that plants primarily take up water to keep themselves cool. We covered this in Humidity 101. They suck up water via their roots only to spew the vast majority of it back into the air as water vapor through tiny pores in their leaves called stomata, aka transpiration. Now, if you could shrink yourself down and teleport yourself inside a leaf, you'll find conditions in there to be very moist and humid indeed, and we're still talking about leaves. Gases inside a healthy leaf are 100% saturated with moisture, and this creates pressure, referred to as a saturated vapor pressure. We'll give this the catchy title VPSAT. Okay, so now we have this pressure inside the leaf, but what about the stomata? The tiny little leaf pores. Think of these guys as a gateway between the super moist and humid internal world of a leaf and your grow room's environment. When humid and dry air meet, what happens? They try to equalize and balance out, of course. So if your grow room is hot and dry, water vapor will exit your leaves more quickly, increasing the transpirational demand on your plants. Whereas the air in humid grow rooms isn't so different to internal leaf conditions, so less water vapor can escape. Are you with me? Okay. Think of it like this. VPD is a measure of the drying effect of the air around your plants. A high VPD number means a major drying effect. A low number means a minimal drying effect. Put more scientifically, VPD is the difference or deficit between the saturation vapor pressure inside your plant's leaves, VPSAT, and the vapor pressure of your grow room, VP air. Okay, it's time for a VPD calculation example. Note that I've made a VPD calculator available too in the description below. Say your grow room's lights have been on for a few hours and the air temperature is 25 degrees Celsius or 77 degrees Fahrenheit. The relative humidity is 50%. That is, your grow room's air is holding half of its maximum capacity. Using an infrared thermometer, you can measure the temperature of a leaf at the canopy to be 73.4 Fahrenheit or 23 degrees Celsius. You now have all the data needed to calculate your VPD, grow room air temperature, leaf temperature, and relative humidity. Your VPD is the difference between the saturated vapor pressure inside the leaf, VPSAT, and your grow room's vapor pressure, VP air. To calculate VPSAT, you take your leaf temperature in degrees Celsius and plug it into the following equation where T is your leaf temperature. And hey, to two decimal places, we see that the VPSAT equals 2.81 kilopascals. Next, we calculate the vapor pressure of your grow room's air. Basically, it's the same equation as before, save an adjustment at the end for your grow room's relative humidity. T is now your grow room's air temperature, and H is the relative humidity. In our example, our grow room's air is 25 degrees Celsius. Blah, 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 and after that quick math excursion, we calculate the vapor pressure of our grow room's air to be 1.58 kilopascals. Thus, our vapor pressure deficit, da-da-da-da, is VPSAT minus VP air, or 2.81 minus 1.58, making 1.23 kilopascals, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so what does this mean in practical terms? Well, let's say that you're cultivating fast-growing, heavy-fruiting annuals, the sort of plants that a lot of you appear to be growing by the questions and comments I receive. For propagation and early vegetative growth, you should be shooting for a low VPD, so your tender new plants with underdeveloped root systems aren't forced to transpire too much. A VPD of 0.4 to 0.8 kilopascals is ideal. Once your plants are established, 0.8 to 1.2 kilopascals is recommended for healthy transpiration. This would apply to both vigorously growing plants and annuals in transition or the early budding or flowering stage. In mid to late flowering, your plants need to transpire the most. 1.2 to 1.6 kilopascals is a sensible range. This reflects the fact that lower relative humidity, around 40 to 45%, is often recommended for the flowering stage as it tends to create a higher VPD. Anything below 0.4 could lead to mold and plant disease issues, as well as poor nutrient uptake, especially calcium. Basically, your plants aren't transpiring enough. VPDs over 1.6 put your plants in danger of over-transpiring and becoming stressed. This can lead them to taking up too much nutrient and resulting toxicity issues. Obviously, you need to weigh your VPD against your plant's life cycle development stage. Some species, cultivars, and phenotypes can tolerate wider VPD ranges, and others are a lot more fussy and need to be dialed in over several crop cycles. Note that your leaf temperature should read lower than your air temperature. A 2 degrees Celsius gap, around 3.5 degrees Fahrenheit, is healthy. If your leaf temperature is equal to or higher than your air temperature, then your grow lights are probably positioned too close. I hope it makes sense. Let me know if you have any questions. If you're worried your VPD is too high or too low, check out my next video. But for now, this is Everest transpiring heavily. I mean, steadily. Bye-bye.